Hello, my name is Dan Anderson, and I'm a product manager here at OMRON Industrial Automation. Today I wanted to highlight and demonstrate one of our most interesting products in OMRON's predictive maintenance product line, the K6PM thermographic monitoring system. The K6PM is a thermal imaging camera system with monitoring unit that allows for temperature monitoring of any objects within the camera's field of view. Very useful for environments where you need to monitor the temperature of multiple objects that could potentially cause fires or damage if they exceed their normal operating temperature. Now, as you can see, I don't happen to have any control panels running power, injection molding machines, or any other thermally sensitive equipment that might need to be monitored here in my house. But I do love to smoke ribs, pastrami, and especially brisket. So I thought it would be an interesting use case to show how the K6PM is able to monitor the thermal condition of a smoker that we're going to be using to cook these briskets. All right, let's get started. Typically, I smoke brisket at 225°F, which is about 107 degrees Celsius, and I'm going to be using the K6PM to monitor the temperature of the surface of the smoker, which should be a little bit lower than that temperature. I've trimmed my brisket of excess fat and tried to keep that fat cap around a quarter inch in most areas. I've also cross-hatched my brisket to create some additional pockets for the rub to collect. And finally, we find the grain structure of the brisket and we cut off a small piece of the end to reflect that grain structure so I know which way to cut once the brisket is completely covered in bark. Additionally, I like to cut a little into the fat seam, also known as the decal, so I'm able to determine the separation between the point and the flat. One of the steps you can also take right now to make your brisket extra special is to use an injection or a brine, which will help keep your brisket moist and juicy during the smoking process. And it also keeps it from drying out while adding flavor. So I've got my injector filled with brine here, and I'm going to inject at three different points on three different sides at three different depths, as you can see here. Once we're done with the injection, I'm then going to apply my rub. To start, I cover the brisket with a binder. In this case, yellow mustard, which will mostly burn off when we do the smoke. Once I've got our rub applied, then we're going to use a jacquard to tenderize the meat. And more importantly, when we jacquard the meat, that injection we recently applied seeps out of the brisket, connecting with the rub to create a really nice interface where that injection meets the rub and creates a really nice bark. Now we're ready to start smoking the brisket. So I've got my smoker up to 225°F, 107 degrees C, and I've set up the K6PM thermal monitoring system shown here. And there are many different trains of thought regarding whether you put the fat side up or the fat side down on the brisket when you start to smoke. I prefer the fat side up, so when the fat starts to melt, it bastes across the brisket, giving you a really nice flavor profile on the surface of each slice of the brisket. So we've got our brisket inside of our smoker, and we're looking around 1.5 hours per pound of brisket, which means this 11-pound brisket after trimming will probably take us somewhere between 16 and 18 hours to smoke. But we'll monitor the internal temperature during this process and we'll know exactly where we are. So we've hit around 165 degrees internal temperature on the brisket and we're coming up on what's known as the stall. So what's going on right now is that the brisket has reached a high enough temperature where it's starting to sweat out all of that moisture inside of the brisket. And that evaporative cooling is basically causing that internal temperature to stop rising for an extended period of time. So what we'll want to do next is wrap the brisket in aluminum foil in order to seal in as much of the moisture as possible after it's taken as much of the smoke flavor as it can. We'll continue to smoke the brisket until we reach an internal temperature of 200 degrees, which I won't be showing in this video just for the sake of time. Once we reach our desired temperature, we'll take it out, wrap it in a towel, and let it cool for about an hour. And it'll start soaking up some of those juices back into the brisket. And now we're ready to serve. I recommend a large knife with a serrated blade, and we want to note the side that we cut off earlier so we can cut against the grain structure. We should also note where the decal is because that separates the point side from the flat side. So let's separate the point from the flat, find the grain structure, cutting against it, and then cutting the brisket into pencil width slices so we can start serving it to our guests. All right, so now we're separating the point side from the flat side, cutting into the decal right here, which is this fat seam that separates these two pieces of meat. that nice smoke ring. And now we're going to be chopping up the flat side against the grain structure in pencil width slices. So during this whole process, I was able to use the K6PM thermal imaging system to monitor the temperature of the smoker shell, and I also turned on my fire table in its field of view to show how the K6PM was able to monitor thermal energy from different fields of view. From the smokers to the fire tables to control panels to hydraulic equipment, the K6PM monitors thermal events in its field of view. It supports programmable alerts and predictive algorithms that can alert you of a critical failure almost an hour in advance. There's also a YouTube clip showing this feature called the K6PM Arrival Prediction, which is linked in the description below. This product can serve the same function as thermal inspection services. So that concludes the video, and I just wanted to say thank you for watching and joining me on this journey today of sharing two of my favorite interests, smoking brisket and demonstrating new OMRON technology. For more information on the K6PM or any of our other predictive maintenance product offerings, please come check us out at automation.omron.com. Thank you.